So here we are with the square baler. And as you can see, I have straw aplenty because we just finished harvesting this field. And you can see already how the bale collector works. I'm just gonna go here. I'm gonna go straight down here now. Why not? So you can see how it works with the square bales. You have three bales at a time that are getting discharged, which makes for a easier cleanup as far as I'm concerned. Ah, so of course that makes life a lot easier, and it makes a life especially easy, and you will see that here next, because that's what I'm showing you guys next, is how the pickup works with the bales. And then you will see how easy it really is to load a complete truck, how fast you can load a complete truck with these little gadgets, one call them. Because really, you could just have the tube. That bale collector is just a nice thing anyway. 12:30 here. But again, just zooming in here on the baler. Okay, so the last three bales, and of course we could have just continued forever, but now I'm gonna show you guys how easy it is really to load a truck. Of course you can use the loading wagon, but keep in mind this is a more cost-effective solution what we have here, because the 1230 is nowhere near as expensive as a loading wagon would be, or an automatic bale loader would be. Instead you have this one, and you buy the three baler pickup, and you're set, because pretty much every farm has at least one flat deck truck, or a truck that can carry bales, and you might as well just load them manually then. But I am going to show you guys here how easy that is now, and after that we're gonna take those bales back to the palletizing hall there, and I am going to show you guys the part where we're going to be palletizing stuff, straw in fact, with the stationary shredder. So that said, I will see you guys once we are starting loading bales. All right, so now we are here in the wheel loader, loading them wheels. No, we're not loading wheels, we're actually loading straw. So here we go, and we're gonna load those five bales onto the truck. If the truck is actually long enough, that might be too much though for this particular setup, which, as I said, I tried it with the oh yeah, look at that, that is going to be too much, huh? Well, that is unfortunate, but okay, I'm just gonna leave that at that. And we're gonna grab a three pack from back there, just like I initially intended to. And yes, of course, People might say, oh, well, you said it's as easy as doing it with the auto stacker. Nope, never said that. But I said it's a lot easier and a lot faster than it would be if you only use the old method of picking one up with a fork, bringing it to the truck, setting it down, picking another one up with a fork, setting them down, and so on and so on. This is not gonna work, is it? I'm gonna start with the trailer. There. Three bales on the trailer. Now, if I had any sense of depth perception here right now, which I don't have because I have the darn instruments right in front of me. There we go. And we'll just let go of them. Wonderful. And we get the next three. As I said, you can definitely see how that would be a lot easier if you would use three bales with a three bale fork. That would make all the difference in the world. And again, we grab those. But yeah, it's really just like, yeah, when you only have three to deal with, and you don't have to worry about all this other jazz. I'm gonna move this truck because the position of this truck is less than ideal. I guess I could, in this particular situation, I could load four in one go and would be good. And I think we might be actually try that. Maybe five is too much. Five is just too long. But if you have a longer trailer, then five would be ideal. I am almost tempted to try to see how long it would take me to do this manually. Hey, don't move so much. Oop. There. Ha 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 ha. Would be nice if you pay attention and actually only hit the gas when you drive backwards, but I guess it's too much to ask, isn't it? So we're gonna go and grab the next three. Oh, there they are. Come on, come on, come on, come on. And gotcha. There. And you want to have a sizable, like, not the smallest of what's gonna happen here? Are we gonna lose it? Maybe. I didn't have it completely. And this is stuff that can happen to you in real life, that you don't have the bales completely the right way. And in real life, even more so, because in real life, sometimes, so at least I had the luck with a couple of square bales, that I took them just in the right angle and I cut right through the baler twine, and I was really, really, really impressed. Not nearly as much as my boss was, though. But hey, it's a whole different story. There, now I got it. Yeah, that's better. Shouldn't do that either. It's bad practice to lift your load that high while you are traveling. And boop. This is as high as we can go safely. And I use the term safely very loosely here. 1, 2, 3, 4 straps. Yeah, good enough. If I would have paid any more attention, then... Okay. Anyways, let's go ahead here and grab those three here. You can also see really how this would make sense in a multiplayer environment, where you have more drivers for the machines. Like so. And the one on the side might come loose again because I didn't catch him completely. But overall, you can definitely see how the lock script does work for those. And that's not gonna work on my part here. That's what happens if you haven't done it in a while. See how this is gonna work out. This is our last chance. And let go. I might be able to push you guys a little bit there. Perfect. Back up. There we go. Yeah, of course, driving with a wheel and with joystick and with track IR makes this whole process a little bit easier, but still you have to have some kind of routine with it. There. Just like that. Swing around, and ideally, see, if I would have done it, like, there was a time, and it's not even that long ago, but when I was streaming farming every day, then I would have been lined up here right from the get-go, but unfortunately those times are long gone. But that said, those times are coming back, because... Because I decided that I am going hard and heavy again on the farming simulator, especially while you've seen it probably already on the streams, because that's pretty much all I'm streaming anymore. Because farming is my happy place. It's my personal happy place where I don't have to worry about anything, and it's just fun. So, we're gonna be putting those down, ideally without wrecking the other ones below it. Just like so. Boop. Alright. And number 3. Yeah, I think 4 would have been the golden number here. But again, if you have only 3 bales, then you have to pick up a third one or a fourth one from every other load. And then you're going to end up with a lot of back and forth. And I just... I mean, this video is long enough as it is for a simple let's play. Well, I guess, as I said, it's kind of a combination out of let's play and showcase video. And let me know how you like this format of showcase video / let's play. I personally do like it because it gives me a chance to refine my skills a little bit too. And... yeah, just to showcase you guys a little bit, or just to show you guys real time how this all works. Of course, there will be cuts. Of course, there is editing involved. That is just the nature of the beast. I recorded this in 2 different sessions because, well, different reasons. I don't want to bore you with the details. But let's put this last load on the truck. And I will see you guys over at the pellet factory. There. Alright, so, welcome back here. And now, we are just gonna unload the stuff here in a very quick fashion. I'm not super worried about how nice this is, because we're gonna do this 2 different ways. But I will say that much. Unloading with these tools is a breeze. Now we're gonna take, and this is the one, remember, that I showed you guys in the beginning. This is the fork, or the bale picker upper, if you will, that grabs them vertically 3 at a time. So I definitely want to do this with the... yeah, with a telehandler, because otherwise you won't be able to reach. Or another option is to back this truck up to a ramp and then actually drive on drive on top of the drive on top of the truck itself. But this shall be all that I'm gonna unload, because now I'm gonna show you guys quickly how the stationary works are working here. Now I could of course load the pallets as we have them back here. Remember, here our hay, that would be here, and then I can come with a shovel and grab them out of here and transport them over there. Or what I can do and what I am going to do is, well, first of all, we need to start the tractor. Like so. And then we're gonna turn on this machine. And now I could, of course, just go ahead, since I have them already loaded here, and load them one at a time on there. But just for the sake of showing you guys everything here working, we are going to use... that is cute. This is gonna be cute. I have to look down like a crazy person to be... Okay. Apologize for the camera angle, but that's because I'm using Track IR, and that is, well, shall we say, less than ideal for that. So we're gonna grab one bale, and I'm not gonna make this a huge thing here. I'm just gonna grab one bale. There. This is a little bit annoying. Well, it still works though. And then I'm just gonna open this and maybe 4 weeks later. There we go. Wonderful. And there you can see now how the straw gets chopped up into small pieces. And then, as I said, with molasses as well as water, it gets all clumped up and comes then here over the conveyor belt. Goes into the hopper. But at this point, of course, gonna go straight out of the hopper into this hopper here. And it gets then packaged up over this conveyor belt, which turns it. See? Yeah. How wonderful. Hopefully we can see this is enough for one pallet, I hope. I don't know how many of those go on one pallet, to be honest with you, so we have to just wait. Or on one skid, if you will. There. No, 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 don't take it away again. Closer. Up, 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 up. There we go. Now we should be seeing... Ah, here we go. Perfect. So now we should be seeing also the last step of this process, and that is... Oh, perfect. Perfect vantage point here. Yeah, I should have... Okay, I'm gone. Silly safety. And there is your pallet full of pallets. Lieferschein. Let's read it. Creative Mesh UG. Oh yeah, right. That's right. BM Modding. Creative Mesh. I think it's the same. And here we have the pallets. Quite a good pallets, 20 kgs, a lot of them. So yeah, you've seen it all now, guys. There's nothing more to show you guys of this add-on, but as I said, I think it's worth the money. and I hope you enjoyed this, granted, very long video, but just to show everything, I think it was worth it. I did enjoy it. I hope you did too. Leave a comment if you liked it. Leave a comment also if you're gonna get this DLC or not, and I will talk to you guys very soon. Thank you so much for watching. This is the Northern Alex signing off. God bless.